Many of you know our Patrick Elwood for his work here on WGN. What you may not know is all the charity work he does when he's not on the air.
It is so significant. Patrick will soon be honored with a prestigious humanitarian award. As Nancy Liu reports, the recognition will bring him full circle to his birthplace.
It's a little intimidating. It's definitely a great honor.
As Little Company of Mary Hospital celebrates its 90th year of serving residents in and around Evergreen Park, it is also celebrating one of its most notable baby alums.
April 25th, Patrick Timothy Elwood. Wait a minute, I was the first baby born that day.
Patrick's 1967 arrival is documented in the hospital's books of baby alums. Perhaps fittingly, the youngest of nine children from Marge and Tom Elwood followed some major local news.
There was the Oklahoma tornado on the 22nd, so a lot of the neighborhood was completely demolished when my dad and my mom were taking me home.
After growing up in the neighborhood, graduating from Brother Rice and then the University of Texas, Pat's TV career eventually brought him home. He is extremely proud of his family. Wife Katie and children Marty, Alexis, Callista, and Grady have all helped him to help others.
So we're back again to shave our heads, right? To raise money for pediatric cancer research. Part of our school's challenge through St. Baldrick's.
With a big assist from Katie, Pat's St. Baldrick's School's Challenge has raised about $15 million for the St. Baldrick's Foundation.
This is my daughter, Callista.
Perhaps karma came around a few years ago after a cruel twist of irony. Pediatric cancer hit home. Daughter Callista was diagnosed with a brain tumor.
The doctor said, I actually have been working on this technique of removing this tumor through a grant that I received from the St. Baldrick's Foundation.
After another tumor scare last year, Callista is still battling Cushing's disease.
I was angry that, you know, this little girl had to go through this again.
When Callie's tumor came back? Yeah. She's still battling. She's a very strong girl, but we're still fighting it.
The Elwoods took on another fight in 2015 when 28-year-old nephew Ryan committed suicide. He was a decorated hometown firefighter with a bright future.
It was the prototypical happiest guy in the room. Mm-hmm. You never would suspect it for a minute.
Never. Always had a smile on his face.
Yeah.
Always.
So we just didn't want his death to, you know, all of that to go in vain.
So the family established REACT, the Ryan Elwood Awareness, Counseling, and Training Fund. There is screening and support services for first responders dealing with PTSD.
They're not used to asking for help.
Correct. They're used to giving the help.
Patrick has quietly helped others under the radar for years. He was reluctant to accept this year's Mary Potter Humanitarian Award.
He was absolutely, truly floored that the community wanted to honor him. Because he feels like he's been giving back for all these years and just did it so graciously without ever wanting any accolade.
None of this would be possible without you.
Pat credits Katie for fueling his philanthropy. They are forging on to help even more first responders and kids with cancer.
We're still going.
Yeah.
It's a lot of work.
We're
still going.
Sure.
There's a lot of kids in need, and there's a lot of research that needs to be done. So we're going to continue.
Pat is already gearing up to go bald again in March for St. Baldrick's.
Together we can make a difference.
Oh, we love him. Mm-hmm. Congratulations, Patrick. And that was Nancy Liu reporting. Patrick will receive the venerable Marty Potter Humanitarian Award at the Little Company of Mary Crystal Heart Ball February 1st at the Field Museum. For more information on the event, St. Baldrick's, and REACT, you can find the links at our website, WGNTV.com.
You know, I love, too, that what Nancy said is so true. He does it quietly.
Yes, exactly.
He's a